Let us see the inner working of second program. See the line, this one, integer sum semicolon. This is not an executable statement. It is only a directive to the compiler that sum is an integer type of variable. That is, sum will consume 2 bytes of memory. Remember that this statement won't allocate any memory. Now, see the next statement. That is, sum is equal to 100 semicolon. This is an executable statement. This is the initialization of variable sum by the value 100, where 100 is an integer constant. After execution of this statement, the memory will be allocated. Since sum is an integer type of variable and length of integer type of variable is 2 bytes, the 2 bytes memory space will be allocated for variable sum. Now see the diagram. This rectangle, so this set of rectangle is a part of primary memory. Thus, we know that the smallest unit of memory is 1 bit, B-I-T. A set of 8 bits is a 1 byte, single byte. In this diagram, each rectangle is a single byte. Every byte has a memory address. You see, the first one has memory address 51, the second one memory address 52, third one memory address 53, and so on. For accessing memory, the address is required. This address specifies the memory location. Now, our variable sum consumes 2 bytes. I have shown this by using green color, this one. There are 2 bytes for variable sum. The byte whose address is 52 and 53 are allocated for variable sum. These 2 bytes contains the integer constant 100. I have shown it over here. Is it clear? Now, what is the job of printf statement? Printf statement will go to the address of this memory location. It will fetch this value and display it at screen of the monitor. Now, one more point which I have not explained in previous program is this return 0. Here we have used int before main. So main will return an integer value to the operating system. Here I have written that value. So this statement is a must. We must include this statement over here. Is it clear? Thank you.